Today we hear that every good and perfect gift is from above and comes from God, and that we are called to be a kind of first fruits of His creatures, and that we are given, essentially, three things to do in order to accomplish that to which we have been called. Listen carefully, speak slowly, and stop with the anger. Let's put that more poetically, as in the Epistle of James, be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath. The first one, be swift to hear, like what we are doing right now. If we live life attempting to hear the still, small voice of God, and He speaks to us day in and day out, we will come to know more fully what life consists of in reference to both things temporal and things spiritual. Number two, be slow to speak. You know, some folks don't think ahead of time what they are going to say, and that can promote some very destructive communication, you know, idle talk, gossip, empty words that are not at all edifying to anyone. And so a good rule of thumb is, before speaking, remember that what flows out of your mouth cannot be grabbed and put back in. Rather, it's like water over Niagara Falls. It's gone. Third, finally, be slow to wrath, for the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. Now, when we enact those three things in life, we have allowed God to do what we pray for this day, to order our unruly, that is disorderly, our unruly wills and affections or emotions. And the result is that we can then love the thing which He commands and desire that which He promises us. What's the thing that God commands? It's the summary of the law, love. Love God with all your heart, mind, and soul, and your neighbor as yourself. What is that which He promises? Well, we've got some of it. We've got love, joy, peace, then the big three, really. The forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting in the presence of God Himself, love. Very powerful and yet basic to we who are followers of Jesus. And that brings us to the gospel narrative in which Jesus tells His disciples of future events. Did you ever think when you were a child that you just wanted to be with your folks and never move out? I bet you got rid of that thought pretty quick, huh? I suppose if we could remember far enough back, we all at least thought that for a moment or three. And with the economy being what it is in our own day and age, I'll bet you a handful of young adults wish they were back at home. But did you think it would really be nice to be with your folks all your life? Well, you could have if they took really good care of you. If they not only loved you, but showed you that love also and educated you. You know, having great parents is comforting. That is, good parents, great parents strengthen their children for life in this world. And especially when realizing that we live in not only a sinful, but discomforted world. The haven of a loving family can be extraordinarily powerful. So let's look to the gospel. And what do we see? We see Jesus making His disciples ready for His inevitable departure, His ascension into heaven. Anxiety-producing thoughts, perhaps. However, Jesus tells His disciples of the goodness to come, that the Comforter, the Strengthener again, the Holy Ghost, the Spirit of Truth, will guide them into all truth and will show them of things to come. And so, when Christ ascended, they were given the powerful presence of the Holy Ghost. And you know, that has happened to us too. In our baptism, when we first received the Holy Ghost and later on in confirmation when we were strengthened in that gift. Do you remember the confirmation prayer that was prayed over you? Strengthen them, we beseech thee, O Lord, with the Holy Ghost, the Comforter, and daily increase in them thy manifold gifts of grace, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and ghostly strength, the spirit of knowledge and true godliness, and fill them, O Lord, with the spirit of thy holy fear now and forever. All things in this life come to an end. Some things we experience are both painful and almost incomprehensible. And yet, Jesus promised his disciples and us the Holy Spirit, the presence of God, to guard, protect, and enable us also to see things clearly and to understand all truth. Even in the midst of the darkness of life, you and I see Jesus. And we hear him say, "The Spirit of truth will guide you into all truth, and he will show you things to come." Do you believe that? To order our unruly wills and affections, to do the difficult and the impossible, to enable us to be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath, and to give us that ever-present sense of peace and love so powerful that we know by God's grace that we will be his in the end. We are not comfortless. We have his presence. See you next week.